It's different.
感觉自己血压上升.
忘点外卖.
Why did I start my YouTube channel speaking English? The reason was really simple. First,
Vlogger 跟自己男朋友说了一天中文，然后男朋友不知道他在说什么，就很逗。我看完了之后，也很想尝试一下一天只说中文，或者是对着镜头说中文。 So that's gonna be today's vlog. 我能行，我可以。
Are you sure about that?
现在是早上8:40. 第一件事，我想去趟超市，因为咖啡没了，我的冰箱基本上已经空了。所以现在我要去工作一会儿，然后待会儿我们一块去超市。 Alexa, stop the music. Reporting 已经搞定了，现在8:55, 时间有点紧张，飞速去趟超市。 Let's go. 开了两个会，感觉自己血压上升，就是发现今天要干的事儿挺多的，然后发现今天一下午的会，所以该干的事儿呢，不知道什么时候要干。我觉得可能我现在这么焦虑，是因为我肚子里面空空如也，我觉得我该吃饭了，因为今天起得很早，但一直没有吃饭，现在已经11:30了，所以我们去做午饭吧。嗯，stretch
first.
Forest. 它好像是个中国的 app， 我感觉很多人都已经知道，但就是你用这个来种各种各样的树，你有一个自己的花园吧 ，basically， 然后就是你可以种不同的品种，然后不同的时长，然后不看你的手机，我觉得还挺好用的。这是我今天新买的一个树种，这什么树来着？我看一眼，这我买的是 camellia， 但我不知道这是中文名是啥，待会儿可以查一下。 好看的街上，然后这春天的感觉，而且 ，Oh my God, there's a black cat. Hi, baby. Hi. Do you want to say hi to the camera? Hey. All right. Bye. 我从来没有用过帕老师的 B 站。 他在 B 站有近乎500万的粉丝， so that's like 5 million. So almost as many as she has on YouTube. 中国市场真的是不容忽视，朋友们。
就是我感觉我其实跟很多家人朋友也都在聊，就是我做视频的初衷，包括我怎么选择语言。我第一个视频是我大一的时候做的吧，在 YouTube 上。然后我做那个 vlog 之后，其实就之前想挺多，就是我到底要用英文做还是用中文做。因为我做视频一部分的原因是希望我在国内的朋友啊、家人啊能知道一下我的生活近况啊什么的。 Felt like I was really torn about the language I was supposed to use. I feel really compelled to only stick to one language, which is kind of stupid. Oh my God, it's dripping. Cool. This requires full concentration. Where was I? Why did I start my YouTube channel speaking English? The reason was really simple. First, most of my family and most of my friends comprehend English well enough, so they would understand what I'm saying most of the time. But at the same time, my American friends or non-Chinese friends can also enjoy my vlog and my videos. And also, one of the reasons why I like used English in my vlog is because I want to use it as a practice. 就是我大一刚来上学的时候，对我英文就是英文口语还没有那么好，没有那么 fluent. I was born and raised in China. I went to public school. I didn't go to international school. When college first started, like it was really stressful. I have to take like college level courses in English. And when I walked into that bio lecture, they're talking about amino acid and cystic fibrosis. And I'm just like, what the heck is going on? Like that was really overwhelming for me. So I think part of the reason why I use English in my video is just to have an additional practice of me speaking English and like processing English in my brain and like I'm just trying to immerse myself. 但我觉得就是其实还有一点，你作为一个外国人在美国，其实你无形之中有这种压力去，通过这种方式，我能够更好的去打破这个社会或者是我身边的人对中国留学生的刻板印象。Somehow I feel like if I speak more perfect English, I would be able to avoid racism. and xenophobia. And I could assimilate, I could protect myself better, I could appear to be more intelligent, which is just so stupid. Just because you speak English with an accent or you don't speak English well, like, doesn't mean you're not an intelligent person. That's just the stupidest thing. I think a lot of the social pressure coming from the society that I'm in kind of propelled me speaking English in my video. 但我觉得今天就是说了一篇中文，或者是想了很多，就是作为一个，就是文化杂种。What am I trying to say? 作为一个就是在两种文化下长大的人，就是我感觉我跟我很多的朋友都有过这样的对话，但我从来没有想过怎么去系统的总结我这些年来的一些感悟，然后把它做成一个视频。其实我想了一段时间了，然后我觉得今天做这个 vlog 是一个很好的契机，去让我更系统的去反思这方面的事情。 I think I'm gonna read I've been reading Days of Distraction by Alexander Chang. It's just so, so deeply relatable. It made me reflect on being an East Asian in America. It gave me a lot of insight on what it's like to be in an interracial relationship. I feel like it's not necessarily offering me an answer to things, but just giving me something to connect to is like beneficial enough for me.It's been granting me some peace of mind, which I'm really grateful for, and I'm excited to finish the rest of the book. I'm like halfway through. Why am I speaking English again? Oh my god.
谢谢大家观看我的视频。
Alright, I give up. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment down below if you find this relatable. Hope you're having a great day. Hope you enjoy this vlog. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.